Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to discuss about Process Builder in Salesforce. If you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. So now we are going to discuss about Process Builder that is available in Salesforce. So first, introduction of Process Builder. So here 4 points are listed, in which first point is Process Builder provides declarative process automation. Second point is Lightning Flow provides this point and click automation tool, that is Process Builder. So now what is Lightning Flow? So Lightning Flow is the name of product. And in fourth point, you can read Process Builder and Flow Builder are names of the tools. So Lightning Flow provides two tools. One is Process Builder that we are discussing in this video. And in my another video, you will get to know about Flow Builder, that is also tool of Lightning Flow. So Lightning Flow provides two tools, Process Builder and Flow Builder. So if you want to create processes, then you can use Process Builder. If you want to create flows, then you can use Flow Builders. So in this video, you will get to know what are processes and how we can use Process Builder. So this video is theoretical. And in my another video, you will see how we can practically implement Process Builder. So to understand theoretical requirement of Process Builder, this video is helpful. Otherwise, you can view a playlist related to Process Builder where practical demonstration videos are also available related to Process Builder. So now when to use Process Builder? You can use Process Builder when requirement is to start automated business process behind the scene. So in background or in backend, you want to automate any business process while certain criteria happens. So you can implement Process Builder for that purpose. So now when processes start, so three things are available here. First is a record changes. So here two sub points are available: when a record is created and when a record is created or updated. So in this scenario, your processes will be starting. Second point is a platform event message is received. So this is the second point through which processes will be starting. And third is it's invoked by another process. So with these three points, you might be understood how your processes will be starting or when your processes will be starting. So if anyone matches, then your process will start. Now, while defining Process Builder, you need to focus on these four things. You need to select a particular object for which you are implementing Process Builder. Second is criteria. So criteria is very much important, because if criteria matches, then only some processes or actions will be performed. Otherwise, nothing will happen. Then third is immediate actions. So you can define immediate actions like after matching the criteria, your action will be performed. Fourth, you can schedule certain actions. So those actions will be executed at particular point of time. So you can choose either immediate action or you can choose scheduled actions as per your requirement. So after this, what Process Builder can do? So these are Process Builder actions that you can do while implementing processes. So you can read these points. So this is very much important if we talk about interview purpose. So in various interviews, interviewer may ask like what we can do with the help of Process Builder. So you should know all these things that we can do with the help of Process Builder. So first is Apex, second is create a record, third email alerts, fourth flows, fifth post to chatter, then processes, then quick action, then quip, then send custom notification, submit for approvals, and update records. So all these tasks or things we can do with the help of Process Builder. So I will be implementing all the videos related to these actions. Those will cover practical implementation, like how you can use these things in Process Builder. So you can go to my channel and you can search for Process Builder related playlist. And there you will find out all these related videos so that you can understand Process Builder better. So now this is a pictorial representation of Process Builder. Then like if you are going to implement any process in Process Builder, so you will see this kind of UI. So at top right corner, you can see here buttons are available, view all processes, clone, edit properties, and activate. At top left corner, you can see name of process is available. Then two buttons, expand all and collapse all. So as we can define certain criteria here, so these buttons will be helpful then. So I discussed these four things, object criteria and immediate and scheduled actions. So you will see all these things here. So you need to select a particular object on which you can fire this process builder. Then here you can put the criteria. So here I have mentioned a particular criteria like check context, and bottom you can see you can add more criteria. If it is true, then this immediate action will be performed. And we can also schedule actions. So here you can click on add action and then you can add those scheduled actions. Then it will stop. If it is false, then you can add some more criteria. If that criteria will be true, then this immediate action will be performed, or you can also schedule some actions here. And you can also notice that we can add multiple actions for a particular criteria. So if I compare this process builder with workflow, so in workflow, you cannot define multiple criteria for different actions. You can implement a criteria for executing some actions, but in process builder, you can define a criteria for some actions, another criteria for another set of actions, another criteria for another set of actions. And you can also set, like if one criteria is true, then some actions will be performed. And if it is false, then another criteria will be checked and another actions will be performed. So this way you can manage your process builder. So I hope you understood this thing in pictorial representation. You will get familiar more with this while you will watch videos related to practical implementation. So after implementing Process Builder, you need to focus on these three things. You must activate your Process Builder so that it works. So while implementing Process Builder, you need to define object, criteria, and actions. And after implementing those things, you just need to activate your Process Builder. So at top right corner, you can see activate button is available. You can click on this button and your process builder will be activated for execution. Then if you want to edit your criteria and actions and you have already activated your process builder, so then you need to clone it. So you can see a clone button is available. With the help of this button, you can clone your process builder and new version will be created and you can edit your criteria and actions as well. Then if you don't want to execute your process builder while creating or updating records and other things, so you can deactivate it so that it won't work. So these things you need to remember while working with process builder. So I hope you understood theoretically what process builder is, what we can do with process builder. So if you want to watch more process builder related videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and go to Process Builder related playlist and you can watch videos related to Process Builder. So I hope you understood whatever I discussed in this video. Thank you for watching this video.